Atrévete, que te vas a ocupar de los niños. Os quiero tanto a todos. Si tuviese más tiempo...
No, no te puedes morir. Sante, la vida no tiene sentido.
Mi amor, te veré en el cielo. Reza por mí.
Little shit! Can't you do something about that?
Like what? What do you want me to do?
Oh, she's been wailing. I could barely concentrate.
Oh, goochie-goochie-goochie-goochie-goochie-goo!
That's going to get very tired very, very quickly.
She's hungry.
Well, we're all hungry, but nothing in her wails and screams is going to change that.
Oh, you do go on, Mother.
Last time we ate, she had the lion's share because you said she looked peaky.
She was. She still is. Look at her.
I can't. I might not be responsible for my actions.
God, you do go on.
It was your decision to keep the creature. The least you could do is look after it.
Don't call my daughter a creature.
Well, make it shut up then.
Yes! Selfish bitch.
I'll go out in a minute. I'll get us.
You will not. You'll wait till the others get back, and then we'll go together.
I won't be long.
Remember last time?
Why do you have to keep bringing that up?
Because you never learn.
Well, maybe I didn't have a very good teacher.
Or maybe you're just dense.
I know. Why don't you rub some on her gums? It might take the pangs of hunger away.
And what does God do to people who stray from the path of righteousness?
He burns them in hell.
That's right, Andrew, he burns them in hell.
Peace off.
Yes, that's nice, isn't it? That's better. Oh, yummy, yummy. Oh, yummy, yummy.
You know, sometimes I think it would have been better if you'd just let her die when you had the chance.
Mother!
Well, at least we'd get some peace.
Take no notice, sweetie. Grandma's just jealous.
Because she knows that Grandpa Ralph has found a new little plaything.
Liar!
Truth hurts, doesn't it?
So does the back of my fist, you cocky cow!
Touched a nerve, have I?
Your father dotes on me.
Well, when he's here, he does seem to spend an awful lot of time away these days.
But he does that for us!
I don't think I'd like that very much. Has he said something? Well, you'll have to ask him yourself.
I'm so bored of it all, Alice. Really, really bored. And hungry. Horribly, horribly hungry. That film I watched today, I swear to you, when the silly little bitch succumbed to the brain tumour, I had a little tear come to my eye. Not because I felt compassion for her, perish the thought, but because I was jealous. I wanted to be her to make it stop. There comes a point when the tedium of this existence just makes you want it to end, for it to end. Do shut up, Mother. Don't answer it.
Why?
It could be anyone.
So?
Alice!
Hello.
How are you today?
Who is this?
Do you have a few moments to talk about Jesus?
Come in then.
Mother, may we help you?
Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Saviour?
You lost me.
Do you read your Bible?
No. Should I?
Surely it can't have escaped your attention that we are moving swiftly toward the end of days.
Can't say I've noticed.
It will be a time of great unrest, when the living will envy the dead, and there will be devastation and heartache on a scale the like of which most of us can't possibly imagine. But don't worry. There's still time for you to join us and have an exclusive seat at the right hand of God.
Do you hear that, Alice? We can sit at the right hand of God.
Embrace God's love, and anything is possible.
And if we don't?
Then you will burn. Burn in a hellish eternity beyond your comprehension, begging for release come the last days.
Those of us who love freedom must work together to do everything we can to disrupt, deny, and bring to justice these people who have no soul, no conscience, people that hate freedom.
Surely you can't deny that things are heading to a place where only a miracle can change things. Did you know that 3 times as many people fell victim to war in the 20th century as in all the wars from the 1st century AD to 1899? It's true! I would not lie to you! If you spread out all those deaths evenly over that period, war would have killed over 2,500 people every day. That's over 100 people an hour, round the clock, for 90 years. Can you imagine that? Doesn't that tell you something?
That's man, isn't it? And the human's interpretation of free will that screwed things up.
Exactly. Ever since the serpent winked at Adam and Eve and upset the natural order of things, nothing has ever been the same.
Do you believe in Adam and Eve?
Andrew and I take the word of our Lord very, very seriously.
Well, I can see that, but honestly, virgin births.
In these times of degradation and permissiveness, it's hard for people to grasp. But Mary... oh, Mary... was a sacred woman.
And a very frustrated one, no doubt.
The rapture is coming.
No, it's not. You're just making that up.
I look at this sick world, and I say, dear God, get us out of here! How can I look people I care about in the eye and not tell them about the wonders of heaven? God's not a burden in my life. He's my greatest joy. Jesus is here. You just have to let him into your heart.
Jesus is here!
Oh, it speaks!
I can feel him! Can you feel him? I feel like foreigner.
I feel like I'm not going to use that word.
Alright, this world! It's been too long! You are not a product of natural selection! You are one of God's celestial beings! And he loves you, child! He loves you! Feel him! Feel God's love! Feel the room! Feel him walk amongst us!
Three little babies lying in bed, two were sick and uttermost dead. little baby's on a shortening way. Mammy's baby loves shortening bread. Mammy's baby loves bread. Mammy's baby loves shortening. Mammy's little baby loves shortening bread.